Bisyata Dishmaya Masechas Megillah Daf Tezvov. We're going to start 11 lines down. Omar Rav Nachman. Malachi, the famous Novi Malachi, ze Mordechai. He was Mordechai a Yehudi. V'lomo nikro shmoy Malachi. Why was he called Malachi? Shehoyo Mishne Lamelech. Malachi is from the term Melech. And Mordechai was the Mishne Lamelech. The Marsha says that being the Mishneh LeMelech, the second in command, made him as important as a Malach. And Malachi is from the same root as the word Malach, an angel. Meisvei, they asked Reb Nachman the Kasha from the Braisa. Baruch ben Neriya, Ushroyo ben Maaseyo, V'Daniel, U'Mordechai, Bilshon, V'Chagai, Zachario, U'Malachi, Kulon Nisnabu, Bishnas Shtaim, L'Daryovish. All those were Nevi'im in the second year of the reign of Daryovish II, the son of Achashverish, that Klal Yisrael would be allowed to rebuild the Beis HaMikdosh. But from the fact that in this list, Mordechai is mentioned separately and Malachi is mentioned separately, it would seem clear that Mordechai and Malachi are not the same people. Tufta, indeed, it's a kasha from this price, on Reb Nachman. Now the Gemara is going to bring another opinion. Tanya, we saw in the Braisa, Om Reb Yeshua ben Korcho. Malachi ze Ezra. Malachi was actually Ezra HaSeifa. Bechachomim Rimrim, Malachi Shmoy. Don't assume that the word Malachi is a title to do with his greatness and really his real name was something else, like Ezra or Mordechai. No, the Chachomim say his name was Malachi. Malachi was Malachi and not anybody else. Omar of Nachman Bar Yitzchok, Mistabra Commander Omar Malachi Ze Ezra. It's probable that Malachi was indeed Ezra. Tachsiv b'Nevius Malachi. In the Nevuah of Malachi it says, Bogdo Yehuda v'soyevo neseso b'Yisrael u'b'Yerushalayim kichilel Yehuda kodesh Hashem ha'she'ohev u'boar bas el necho. The Novi Malachi was complaining about the fact that even whilst they were in Yerushalayim still, they were doing Averis, they were marrying Goyim. The Gemara says, Uman Afrish Noshim Nochris. Who was the Novi that separated all these non-Jewish women from their Jewish husbands? Ezra, it was Ezra. Dechsev, Vayan Shechanyo ben Yechiel, Mibnei Elam, Vayoyma le'Ezra, Anachnu Mo'alnu Beilekeinu, Vanoyshev Noshim Nochris. Ezra was the one that separated these Noshim Nochris from their Yiddish husbands. And since both Sefer Malachi and Sefer Ezra were discussing the same issues, it's probable that it was the same Novi. Now the Gemara is going to discuss some of the Noshim that we mentioned previously. Ton Rabbonon, we saw in the Braisa, Arba Noshim Yefeifiyois Hoyu Ba'olam. There were four exceptionally good-looking women in the world. Soro, Rochov, Va'avigail, Va'Esther. Uleman Da'omar, according to the Man Da'omar, we saw in Dafyud Gimel Amud Aleph, Esther Yirak Roikes Hoysa, that she was not beautiful, that Esther had a green-colored skin. Mapik Esther, Uma'il Vashti. In place of Esther, the fourth woman is Vashti. Now the Gemara is going to bring another Braisa. Tonu Rabbonon, we saw in the Braisa, Rochov Bishmo Zinza. Anyone who just mentions the name Rochov gets drawn to lust. Yoal Bekoilo. Anyone who hears the voice of Yoal gets drawn to lust. Avigail Bezachirosa. Anyone who just remembers Avigail gets drawn to taiva and lust. Michal bas Shaul b'riyosa. Anyone who sees Michal bas Shaul gets drawn to lust. Now the Gemara is going to elaborate about Rochov. Omer b'Yitzchok kol ha'imir Rochov Rochov. Anyone who says Rochov Rochov miyad nikri. It causes a tumah to be yetzer migufay. Omar Leir of Nachman. Rav Nachman said to Rav Yitzchak, Ano Amena, Rochov Rochov, Reichbasli. I said Rochov Rochov, and nothing happened to me. Omar Leir of Yitzchak said to Rav Nachman, Kiko Amena, Beyoida Ubamakira. What I said is only true and relevant to somebody who knew her and recognized her. And now the Gemara is going back to the Psukim of Megillas Esther, Perek Dalet Posuk Aleph. The Posuk says, Mordechai Yoda es kol asher nasa, vayitzi b'soicho ir, vayizag za'oko gedoilo umoro. Asks the Gemara, my Omar, when it says that Mordechai cried out in the cities, what did he say? Rav Omar, Rav says that Mordechai said as follows, Gova homon me'achashvirish, the rishos of Homon is greater than the rishos of Achashverosh. Achashverosh didn't dream about destroying the entire Klal Yisrael. Haman did. Shmuel Omar Shmuel says that Mordechai cried as follows, Govar Malko Ilo Mimalko Tato. that Hashem, who is the king from high, has overpowered Achashverosh, who is the king from below. Marasha explains that this was a type of tefillah, or possibly nevuah, that in spite of the seeming severity of the gezeira of Achashverosh, Hashem would ultimately bring his downfall. That's how the Marasha explains this Gemara. Rashi seems to say that the Gemara was using a term called Saginar, a borrowed term, but in truth, Mordechai was telling Klal Yisrael that it seems that Achashverosh from down here managed to override the Ratzon Hashem. But the Marasha says it's not probable that Mordechai would speak like that. Continues the Gemara, it says in Pasuk Dalet that when Esther heard Mordechai's cry, Vatischalchil Hamalko Moid, asks the Gemara, Mai Vatischalchil, what does this word mean? Omarav Shapirsonida, she became so afraid that she became Tommy. Rabbi Yirmiyah Omar, Rabbi Yirmiyah says, Shehutzchach Lenikovel, she became so afraid that she had to pass water. Now the Gemara moves to Pasuk Hay. The Pasuk says, Vatikra Esther Lehasoch, Esther called Hasoch. Omar Rav, who was Hasoch? Hasoch Zed Daniel, one of the ministers of the king. He was already a minister in the time of Belshazzar. And the Achashverosh appointed him to stand at service for Esther. V'lomani Kroshmo Hasoch, why was Daniel called Hasoch? Shechotchu Migdulosoi. In the time of Belshazzar, Daniel was a minister over a third of the kingdom. In the time of Achashverosh, he was downgraded to a regular minister. Shmuel Omar, Shmuel says that Daniel was called Hasoch, Shekol Divrei Malchus Nechtochim Arpiv. That he had the last word in everything that happened in the Malchus. He was not downgraded at all. And since he had the last word, he's referred to as Hasoch, meaning to cut, to have the final say. Continues the Gemara. It says in the Pasuk, Vatikra Esther Lehasoch Vatetzavehu al Mordechai Lodas Maze Va'al Maze. Omer Bitzchok. Shol Choloi Esther sent to Mordechai Shema Ovru Yisrael al Chamisho Chum Sheteiru Dechsiv Bohen Mize Umizehim Ksuvim. Could it be that the reason that such a severe gezeira was written against Klal Yisrael because they transgressed the whole Chumash that was given to them at Har Sinai with the Luchos that were written Mizeh U'Mizeh from both sides? That's what Esther wanted to know. And now the Gemara continues with Pasuk Yud Beis. The Pasuk says, Vayagidu leMordechai esdivrei Esther. Esther did not want to go into Achashverosh to ask him to be mevatel the gezeira of Haman. She was afraid Achashverosh would kill her. From the fact that it says Vayagidu, it seems that she did not tell this to Mordechai directly. She sent him a message. It says the Gemara V'ilu Ihu, but Hasoch, who was the one that was sent to Mordechai with this message, Leozu Legabe, he did not go and give this message to Mordechai. And Mikan, from here we see, it's a minig derech eretz, She'ein Meshivin ala Kalkola. Mordechai sent Hasoch to Esther to encourage her to go into Achashverosh, and it seemed that he failed with the Shlichus. Esther didn't want to go in. And since Esther didn't receive the Shlichus graciously, therefore Hasoch didn't go back to Mordechai to tell him this. And that's why Esther had to send the message with somebody else. Now the Gemara is moving to Pasuk Tezayin. Esther said to Mordechai, Leich kenois es kol ha-yehudim ha-nimtzoim b'shushan v'tzumu olai v'goymer ad uvechein ovoi el ha-melech asher lo yikados. Explains the Gemara, Omer Rababa, when Esther said, shelo yikados, it means shelo yikados shel Torah. Her going into Achashverosh now was contrary to the general halacha of the Torah. Shebechol yoyim v'yoyim ad achshav bo'inus. V'achshav b'rotzoin, till now, my going into Achashverosh was bo'inus. I had no choice. So any avera that he did was not done with her bechira. But now she was going into him b'rotzoin. V'kashe avadati avadati. Keshem she'avadati mi'beis avo. In the same way as I'm an orphan from my father and mother, kach oivid mimcha. From now on, I'm not going to be mutter to you, Mordechai, anymore, because an eishes ish that engages in these yisurim, not in a matzav of oinus, becomes also to her husband. Now the pasuk goes to pasuk Yud Zayin. Vayavir Mordechai vayas kechila she'tziv sol of Esther. Esther said that everybody should fast for 3 days. What does the word vayavir mean? Omarav shehevir yoim rishon shel Pesach betaynis. He transgressed. Obviously, he was allowed to do that. The din Torah that says that on Yom Tov you mustn't fast, on Pesach you have to eat matzah, and Mordechai was gozer at taynis on the first day of Pesach. Ushmuel Omar. Shmuel says the Ovar Arkuma Demaya, that in order to gather together all the Yidden, he had to cross over some patches of water. which are generally also to do on Yom Tov. And we know that through the city of Shushan, there's a stream, a lake that flows through it. And Mordechai had to cross it in order to call the Eden from the other side of the Nahor. Now the Gemara brings the Pasuk from Perek Hei, Pasuk Aleph of Megillas Esther. Vayhi bayom ha-shlishi vatilbash Esther Malchus. Asks the Gemara, Bigdei Malchus miboyle. Esther didn't wear Malchus, she wore Bigdei Malchus. Omer Belozo, Omer B'chanina, Melamed shelofshes haruach ha-kodesh. From here we see that she was donned with Ruach HaKodesh. Where do we find that Ruach HaKodesh is called a cloth? Ksiv hocha vatilbash, and the Pasuk here says vatilbash, uksiv hosam, v'ruach lovsho es amosai. That the spirit can clothe a being. Amosai was the son of Abigail, a half-sister of David, and a certain ruach clothed him with which he could address the issue with David HaMelech. We won't now go into the whole story there. Now, since the Gemara just brought a memra from Rabbi Elazar ben Chanina, the Gemara is going to bring another memra from the same person. V'omer Rabbi Elazar, omer Rabbi Chanina, Lo'olam al tehi birchas hedyo itkalo be'inecha. Don't be mezalzel with the brocha that a simple person gives you. Shaharishne. There were two G'dayli Ador that were given brachas by Hedyotis, and the brachas were Niskayim. These are the two G'dayli Ador, David and Daniel. David, who gave David a bracha? The Baruchi Aravna. Tichsiv, as it says in the Pasuk, that after David HaMelech bought off our Ravna the land on which he was going to build a Mizbeach, in order to stop the Mageifa that was happening in Klal Yisrael, the Pasuk says, Vayomer Aravno el HaMelech, Hashem Elokecho Yirtzecho. And his bracha was Niskayim. It says after that in the Pasuk, Vayoser Hashem Laoretz, Vatiotzer HaMageifa me'al Yisrael. Daniel was the second God Ladir, the Baruchi Daryovish. He got a bracha from Daryovish. Tichsiv, as it says in the Pasuk, that before Daniel was thrown into the lion's den, Daryovish said, Elohoch di ant polachle betadira, the Hashem that you are constantly serving, hu yeshezvinach. He's going to save you. And his bracha was Niskayim, and Daniel was saved from the lions. Va'omer Abelaz, Omer Abchanina, another memra, Al tehi kilelas hedyot kalo be'inecha. Don't take the curse, even of a simple person, lightly. Shari Avimelech kilele Sora. Avimelech cursed Sora for hiding from him the information that she was actually Avram Avinu's wife and not sister. And he said to her, Hine hu loch ksus einaim. He said to her that in the same way as you covered my eyes when you didn't reveal this information, your eyes too will be covered. V'niskayim ha-bazara, and indeed her offspring, Yitzchok Avinu, became blind, as the Pasuk says, Vayhiki zokin Yitzchok v'techeno einov. Now the Gemara brings another memra from Rabbi Elazar ben Chanina. V'omer Rabbi Elazar ben Chanina, Boy Urei, come and see, Sheloi k'midas HaKadosh Baruch Hu midas basar v'dam. Hashem works very differently from man. Midas basar v'dam, Odom shoyfeis, k'deira, v'achar kach noisin l'teicho mayim. First a person puts a pot on the fire, and only afterwards he puts water into it. Avel HaKadosh Baruch Hu noisin mayim, v'achar kach shoyfeis k'deira. First he gives water, and only afterwards Hashem finds the pot in which to contain the water. L'kayim ha'shen emar, l'koil titoi hamoin mayim. First Hashem puts the dampness, the water, into the atmosphere, and only afterwards Hashem raises the clouds to receive this water. Now Talmud Marsha explains this. Another memra. Anyone who says something in the name of the original composer who said the phrase, maybe Geula La'olam, that's going to be caused to bring the Geula Shenemer, as it says in the Pasuk in Megillas Esther. V'toymer Esther LaMelech b'shem Mordechai. Esther said over to Achashverosh in the name of Mordechai that it was Mordechai that revealed that Bigson V'Seresh were planning to assassinate him. And it was written that way in the Sefer Zichronos. And through that, the Ness of the Hatzolah of Purim came about. V'omer Rabbi Elazar Rabbi Chanina, another memra. Tzadik Ovad. When a tzaddik is nifta, ledore ovad, the generation loses. Who's going to protect the generation? But the tzaddik himself doesn't lose from passing away. His nefesh goes back to where it came from. Moshe la'odom sha'ovdolei margolis. If a person lost a precious stone, a diamond, kol mokim shehi, Anywhere where the diamond is, Margolius Shemo, that's where it's a diamond. It didn't lose its value from the fact that it got lost from its owner. Le'ovdo elo le'baylo. It's only that its owners now don't have access to it. So too, when the tzaddik passes away, the tzaddik stays the tzaddik. It's the generation that no longer has access to the tzaddik, and therefore it's the generation that loses. Now the Gemara is going back to Megillas Esther. To Perek Hei Posuk Yud Gimel, that when Haman saw that Mordechai was not bowing down to him, he said, V'chol zeh inenu shoyveli, v'chol eisa shani royes, Mordechai ha-Yehudi yeshev b'shar ha-melech. Omer b'loz, Omer b'chanina, b'shoah sh'ra'a Haman es Mordechai yeshev b'shar ha-melech, when Haman saw Mordechai sitting by the gates of the king, Omer, he said, Kol zeh inenu shoyveli, it's all not worth it. Asks the Gemara, v'chimishum d'roya Mordechai yeshev b'shar ha-melech, Omer, kol zeh inenu shoyveli? What caused Haman to go so crazy? All the covered in the world he had, and it's all not worth it just because Mordechai is sitting there. Elokud Rav Chisda, this is proof to what Rav Chisda said. Amar Rav Chisda, Ze bo b'pruzbali. Mordechai came with a claim that he was rich. Ze bo b'pruzbati. And Haman was proven to be the pauper. Haman was constantly embarrassed of Mordechai. And deep down in Haman's heart, he knew that all his possessions didn't belong to him. They belonged to Mordechai, because in truth, Haman was a slave to Mordechai. He sold himself to Mordechai. And anything that a slave acquires really belongs to his master. Omar of Papa. The Korulei, people used to call Haman, consequent to the fact that he sold himself to Mordechai, Avda de Mizdavin Betalmei. This is a slave who sold himself for a loaf of bread. The Yalkut in Remez, Tof Tof Resh Nun Vav, brings the whole story that the king gave money to Mordechai and to Haman, and he sent them together with the soldiers to conquer a country. Haman took all the money, bought food, and ate it all up. And when he needed food to feed his army, he had no money left. Mordechai, on the other hand, protected the money, and half of the money was still left with him. Haman came and asked Mordechai if he can lend him that money. Mordechai said, I'll lend it to you on one condition, that you sell yourself to me as an eved. And Haman agreed. In the shtar of that sale, it said as follows, Harei Haman avdei shel Mordechai shekein mochar loy es atzmoi ba'avur kikreis lechem. That's what the Yalkut says, and that's what our Gemara is referring to. Continues the Gemara. It says in Pasuk, Yud Gimel v'chol zeh inenu shoyveli. Now the word zeh normally means this distinct item that I can even point to. It's here. It's this. Says the Gemara, Melameh shekol gnozov shel oisei rasha chakukin aliboy. All Haman's riches and all his value, all his property, were etched on his heart. Some say it means that he was thinking about them all the time. Others say he had a precious stone on which the location of his storehouses were etched out. When Haman would see Mordechai at the gates of the king's palace, he would point towards his chest, Omar Kolzei Neno Sheveli, and would say, this is all not worth it for me. Now the Gemara brings another memra. The Omar Beloz Omar Bchanina, Osid HaKodesh Baruch Hu Liois Atoro, Baroish Kol Tzadik V'Tzadik. Hashem is going to rest his Shechina on every single Tzadik Shnemar, as it says in the Pasuk in Yeshaya, Bayoim Hahu Yiyah Hashem Tzvokos La'ateres Tzvi U'Letzfiras Tif'oro L'Shor Amri. Now the Gemara is going to dash in this Pasuk, Mai La'ateres Tzvi U'Letzfiras Tif'oro. What do these words mean? Says the Gemara, La'oisim Tzivyoinoi U'Lemetzapin Tif'artoi. That Hashem is going to be an Atara. He's going to rest his Shechina on the heads of those who do Hashem's Rotzin, that's what the words La'isim Tzivyoinei means, and to those who are constantly looking for opportunities to praise Hashem. That's what it means, Ulematzapin Tif'artoi. Ask the Gemara, Yochi Lakil, anyone who does the Rotzin Hashem is going to merit this Shechina, even though they are haughty and proud? Says the Gemara, Talmud Leima L'Sh'or Amoy. The word L'Sh'or Amoy means L'mi Shemesim Atzmei Kishiraim. Only the humble people, compared to the food leftovers. He doesn't hold too much of himself. They are the ones that are going to be deserving of this Atara L'Roshei. Now the Gemara is going to darsh in the next Pasuk, in Yeshaya. ולרוח משפט ליישב על המשפט ולגבורה משיבי מלחמה שורה. All those tzaddikim mentioned in this pasuk are the ones who are going to merit this atarah. Who are they? Says the Gemara, leruach mishpat. Who are the ruach mishpat? Those who judge their own spirits. Zehadon es yitzrei. Somebody who judges his own yitzahara and forces him to be chozer b'tshuva. The la yeshiv ala mishpat. Who are the yeshiv ala mishpat? Zehadon din emes lamitoi. Is those who are miyushev whilst engaging in giving judgment. Velikvura, zamisgaber al yitzrei. Somebody who overcomes his yitzahara, he's in this bracket. Meshive milchoma. Who are the meshive milchoma who are going to be deserving of the shechina? Shenoisim v'noisnim b'milchamto shel Torah. They engaged in the milchoma of limud haTorah. Shara, elu tamidei chachomim shemashkimin u'mar'ivin b'bote knesiyos u'b'bote midrashos. Shara are those in charge of the gates, the doors, the first ones in and the last ones out. They are the Tamidei Chachomim. And those Tamidei Chachomim who are the first ones in and the last ones out, they are the ones who are going to be Zoicha to see the Shechina. Now the Gemara darshens the next pasuk in Yeshaya. V'gam eile b'yayin shogu u'vasheichor to'u v'goymer poku plilio. The Gemara darshens this pasuk. Omro midas adin lifnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Midas adin came with a claim. Ribbono shel Olam, ma nishtanu eilu me'eilu? Why are Klal Yisrael better than the Umos HaOlam? Why are only Klal Yisrael Zoicha that the Shechina should rest on them? In the event that the Umos HaOlam would have those qualities mentioned in the previous pasuk, would they not be deserving of the Shechina? Omar lo HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Hashem answered to the Mekatrig, Yisrael osku b'Teira. Klal Yisrael have a shaychus to Teira. Umos HaOlam lo osku b'Teira. Goyim have no shaychus to Teira. The Shechina can only reign on somebody who's osik b'Teira. Omar le, gam eile b'yayin shogu u'vasheichar tou. So to anybody who gets carried away with wine and drink and engaged in similar activities as the Umos HaOlam and are not osik b'Teira, poku plilia, they're going to be judged in the next world. What does the word poku plilia mean? Says the Gemara, ein poku elo gehenim. The word poku means gehenim shenema, as it says in the pasuk when Avigail asked David not to kill Noval, her husband, v'loitie zois lecho lefuka. If you kill my husband, who's not a married b'malchus, it's going to cause you to go to gehenim. Ve'in plilio elo dayonim. The word plilio means judges. Shenemar v'nosam beflilim. Somebody who hits a woman and causes her to miscarry has to pay the father beflilim, the amount of money that the dayonim are kivea that he has to pay. So since poku means gehenim and plilio means dayonim, so the word poku plilio means that they are going to be judged to gehenim. Now the Gemara is going back to the psukim of Megillas Esther. Perek Hei, Posuk Aleph. The Posuk says, Vatilbash Esther Malchus, Vatamoid Bachatzar Beis HaMelech HaPnimis. Omer Reb Levi, the word Vatamoid doesn't just mean that she stood in the Chotzer, because then it should have says, Vatovei Vatamoid. Rather, Vatamoid is a lotion of something stopped happening. As a marshal, it stood in its place. What happened when she entered the Chatzar Beis HaMelech HaPnimis? Says the Gemara, Kivan Sheigia LeBeis HaTzlomim. Since she arrived in the home that housed the Avodah Zarah v'Achashverosh, Nistalkei Meno Shechina. The Shechina left her. When Esther realized that the Shechina left her, Omro, she said, to Pasuk in Tehillim Chof Beis, Keili, Keili, Loma Azavtoni, Shemo Atodon Al Shoigig Kemezid Val Oinus Kerotzin. I didn't intentionally come into the base of Avodah Zarah. I didn't want to be with Achashverosh. And then she thought to herself, Oishemo, maybe the reason that the Shechina left her, Al Shekorosiv Kelev, because I called Achashverosh, a Kelev, a dog, Shenemar, says in the same parak in Tehillim, Hatzilo Mecherev Nafshi, Miad Kelev Yechidosi. And therefore she straightway corrected that, V'chozra V'koratu Ari. She then referred to Achashverosh not as a dog, rather to a lion, Shenemar, as it says, Hoishieni Mipiari. Now moving to Pasuk Beis, Vayikir Ois HaMelech Es Esther HaMalko, Omer Rabbi Yechanon, Shloisho Malachi Ashoris Nizdamnu Lo Bois Isho, three Malachim presented themselves to Esther at that time, Echot Sheikbiya Es Tzavoro, one that lifted up her neck so that Achashverosh could see her face. Ve'echod shemoshach chut shel chesed aleh. Another one caused her to have a particular chen to Achashverosh. Ve'echod shemotach es hasharvit. And another one that stretched the scepter, the royal wand, in order that she could touch it as soon as she came into the chamber. And now the Gemara is going to discuss how far this sharvit stretched. Ve'kamo. How many amos did the malach have to stretch the sharvit? Omer Rabbi Yirmiyah, shtei amos hoya. Before it was stretched, it was 2 amos long. Ve'emidoi al shtei mesrei. And the malach stretched it to 12 amos long. Ve'omri lo, some say, al shesh esrei. The malach stretched it to 16 amos. Ve'omri lo, and others say, al esrim ve'arba. The malach stretched it to 24 amos. Ve'masnita tona. In the braisa we learned, al shishim, that the malach stretched it to 60 amos. The arm of Bisyo Basparoi, when she stretched out her arm to reach for baby Moshe, who was in a basket in the river, and her arm stretched 60 amos. When Oig Melech HaBoshon uprooted a mountain in order to throw it onto Klal Yisrael, and as he lifted it over his head, the ants dug a big hole in it, and it slipped over his head onto his neck. And when Oig wanted to remove the mountain from on his shoulders, his teeth grew 60 amos and bored into the mountain, and that way he could not lift the mountain off his head. Tichsiv, as it says in the Pasuk, Shinei Roshoim Shibarto, V'omer Esh Lokish Al Tikra Shibarto Elo Shirvavto. The Poshup Shat is Hashem breaks the teeth of Roshoim. But the Joshua is that Hashem lengthens the teeth of Roshoim, referring to the teeth of Oig Melech HaBoshon, and they grew 60 amos long. Now the Gemara is going to bring another man to Omar. Rabbi Bar Ef Oifron Omar Mishum Rabbi Eliezer, Sheshoma Mirabui V'Rabui Mirabui. There was a Maseira from a number of generations that the Sharvit was Mosaim. It stretched 200 amos. Gemara is now explaining the Pasuk, Perek Hei, Pasuk Gimel. Vayomer lo amelech, Achashverosh said to Esther, Ma loch Esther hamalko, Uma bakoshoseich, what do you require? At chatzi hamalchus vateos, I'm happy to give you up to half of my malchus. Says the Gemara, that when he said chatzi hamalchus, v'loi kol hamalchus, Achashverosh didn't mean that he was prepared to give her half of his malchus, and he was just saying, I'm not going to give you the whole malchus. Rather, Achashverosh meant, v'loi dovo shechoytetz lamalchus, that he refused to give the one place that splits the malchus. And we know that Achashverosh ruled on the whole world, and there's one place that splits the two sides of the world. Umayniu, what is this place? Binyan Beis Hamikdash. Achashverosh intended to make it clear to her that I will not give you permission to rebuild the Beis Hamikdash. Nachreinim comment here that Achashverosh didn't yet know that she was a Bas Yisrael. So why did he have to exclude from her the option of asking that he give permission to rebuild the Beis Hamikdash? So there's different Mahalchim and Nachreinim. Let's continue the Gemara. In Pasuk Dalet of Perek Hei Megillas Esther, it says, Yovoi Hamelech V'homon Hayoim El Hamishte. Ton Rabbonon, says the Braisa, Ma Raso Esther Shezimno Es Homon. Why did Esther see it necessary that in order to save Klal Yisrael she has to invite Haman to the meal? Rabbi Eliezer Omer, Pachim Tomno Loi. This was a scheme to set up Haman. We find psukim that say that the meals where Roshoim attend often bring their downfall. Shenemar Yehi Shulchonom Lifnehem Lepach. Rabbi Yeshua Omer, Mibeis Ovia Lomda. She heard a child quoting the following pasuk. Shenemar, it says in the pasuk, Imrov sein acho, if your enemy is hungry, hachileu lechem, feed him bread, ki gecholim ata choyte al roishoy. If you give your enemy to eat and drink, your enemy will no longer be able to harm you. Reb Meir Omer. Reb Meir says that the reason Esther invited Haman was kedei shelo yitol eitzov yimroid, was in order to force Haman to subdue himself to Achashverosh and not cause him to rebel against Achashverosh. If Haman would have rebelled, Esther's plan would not have worked. Reb Yehuda Omer. Reb Yehuda says the reason Esther invited Haman, kedei shelo yakiru bo shehi Yehudis. She was trying to cover over the fact that she was a Bas Yisrael, and she did that by inviting Haman, Klal Yisrael's biggest enemy. Ibn Nechemya Omer. Ibn Nechemya says that the reason that Esther invited Haman was kedei shelo yomru Yisrael ochos yesh lanu bebeis hamelech. in order that Klal Yisrael shouldn't feel that they have protector, they have somebody in the Beis HaMalchus, and they don't need to worry about Haman. And they're going to lessen the amount that they trust in Hashem and daven to Hashem. So in order that Klal Yisrael shouldn't think they have anybody in the Beis HaMalchus, she played the part as if she's on Haman's side. Rabbi Yossi says the reason that Esther invited Haman, in order that Haman should spend a lot of time around Achashverosh, and that ups the chances of him slipping up and getting Achashverosh annoyed to the extent that Achashverosh would then kill him, and that's what happened. Rabbi Shimon ben Menasseh said that Esther said, Ulai Yargish Hamokim. When Hashem sees what I'm doing, v'yaselonu nes, that will be reason that Hashem will do a nes for us. Rashi explains that Hashem will see that I had to take measures to even be mekarev, the greatest enemies of Klal Yisrael, or that I had to take measures to humilify myself to this extent, and that will cause the nes. Rabbi Yeshua ben Korcho emir, Asbir Leiponim, Esther said, I'll put on a show as if Haman is my best friend, and then Achashverosh will suspect that Haman has his eye on me, and that way Achashverosh will kill Haman and her Esther, and once Haman is dead, the Gezeirah will be in his battle. Rabbi Gamliel Oimir, Melech Hafachfachon Hoya. Esther knew that Achashverosh had his mood swings, and even if she would convince Achashverosh to kill Haman, by the time he actually finds Haman, he may have changed his mind. So Esther found it necessary to have Haman right there on the premises, that as soon as she convinces Achashverosh to kill him, he'll go ahead and do it straight away before he has time to have any regrets. Omarim Gamliel, Gamliel said that even after all the explanations we've mentioned in the Gemara, Adayin Tzrichin Onu L'Moidoi, we still need the explanation of Rabbi Loza Amoidoi, to Tanya, we saw in the Braisa, Rabbi Loza Amoidoi Oimir, Kin'atu Bamelech, Kin'atu Basorin. By raising Haman up to such heights, it will make Achashverosh jealous that Esther's giving Haman so much attention, and it will make all the other ministers jealous that Haman's getting all this covered. And that way, when Esther gets them to kill Haman, nobody will mind. Achashverosh will be happy that he's gone, and the other ministers will be happy that he's gone. Now the Gemara is giving a few explanations from the Amiroim why Esther invited Haman. Rabbi Omar, Rabbi says that since it says in the Pasuk, Lifnei Shever Ge'oin, before a Rosha has a terrible downfall, Hashem lifts him up high, therefore Esther invited Haman to this meal together with Achashverosh in order that he should really be lifted high, and then he'll be ready for his big fall. Abaye and Rava, the Omrat Arvayu. Abaye and Rava both explained, based on the Pasuk in Yirmiyah, Bechumam Oshis Es Mishteim, Vehishkartim Leman Ya'aloizu, Vyoshnu Shnas Oilam Velo Yokitsu. It's common that Rishoyim meet their downfall through Sudois and Mishteayayin. Continues the Gemara. Ashkechei Rabbi Baravua Leliyahu. Rabbi Baravua met Eliyahu Hanavi. Omer Lei, Rabbi asked Eliyahu Hanavi, K'man Chazio Esther Va'ovda Hachi. Of all the reasons we've seen, what was the real reason that Esther had in mind when inviting Haman to the meal? Omer Lei Eliyahu Hanavi said to Rabbi, K'kulu Tanoi U'K'kulu Amiroi. She had in mind all the reasons of all the Tanoi mentioned and all the Amiroi mentioned. Continues the Gemara. We're moving to Perek Hei Pasuk Yud Aleph. Vayisapir lahem Haman es kvoid oshroi v'roiv bonov. Asks the Gemara v'kama roiv bonov. How many were Haman's children? Omar Rav, Shloshim. Rav says that Haman had 30 children, 30 sons. Asoro Mesu, 10 died a natural death. Vasoro Nitlu, 10 were hung, as we're going to see in the Megillah. Vasoro Machazun El Apsochim, and 10 became poor and hungry, they had to knock on the doors for bread. Rabbonon Omri, the Chachomim in the base medrash of Rav would say, Oison Shemachazun El Apsochim, Shivin Havya. 70 sons would go collecting from door to door, and that's besides for the 20, 10 of which died normally and 10 of which were hung. Tichsiv, as it says in the Pasuk, Sveim Balechem Niskoru, and the Targum Yenison then, Shmuel Perek Aleph, explains that it's talking about the Bnei Haman. And it can't mean it kepshutoi. Sveim means they're satisfied. Balechem niskoru means that they hired themselves in order to have money for bread. If they're satisfied, they don't need bread. Says the Gemara, Al Tikri Sveim Eloshivim. The letters of Sveim are identical to those of Shivim. And the Pasuk is telling us, as a drasha, that 70 of his sons were knocking from door to door, ready to sell themselves for some food or bread. Rami bar Abba Omar, Kulon, all his children, between those that died, those that were killed, and those that became hunger-stricken, Mosaim Ushmoino Havu. The 208, Shenemar, as it says in the Pasuk, Veroiv Bonov, and Veroiv, without the second Vav in it, is the Gematria of 208. Ask the Gemara, Veroiv, but Veroiv has two Vavs in it, but Gematria Moson Varbeisahava is 214. Answers the Gemara Omer of Nachman Bar Yitzchok, Veroiv Ksiv. If you look in the Megillah, you'll see there's only one Vav there. It's written Verav, even though it's read Veroiv. Now the Gemara is moving to Megillas Esther, Perek Vav, Posuk Aleph. Balaylo Hahu Nodudo Shnas HaMelech. That night the king couldn't sleep. Omer Rabbi Tanchoim, Tanchoim says that the word HaMelech in Drush is referring to the Malkui Shel Olam. Nodudo Shnas Malkui Shel Olam. Not Chas HaSholom that Hashem ever sleeps. But there was his Oirus from the Rabbeinu Shleilam that night, in order to save Klal Yisrael. Rabbanon Omri, the Rabbanon say, Nodudu Elyonim, Nodudu Tachtonim. The Malachim from above did everything they could to wake up Achashverosh, and they frightened him that night. And he had voices. He heard the Malachim saying, Achashverosh, Yokofu Toiva, reward those that helped you. Rava Omar, Rava says, Shnas HaMelech Achashverosh Mamash. That it's talking about Achashverosh that got woken up. Naflo Le Milsa B'Dati, a thought entered his mind. Omar, he said, Maide Kamon, Dzaminte Esther LeHamon. What's this new custom that Esther is inviting Haman to a meal? Dilma Eitza Koshokli Ilavei, Dahu Gavra, Demiktele. Maybe the two of them together are planning to kill me, Achashverosh. Hoda Omar. Then he said to himself, Yehocha, can it really be that they're plotting to kill me? Lehava gavra derochim li dava moidali? Is there nobody who loves me enough that they're going to tell me about this scheme? Hoda Omar. Then he said to himself, maybe the reason no one is telling me, Dilma ikka inish da ovad bitevusa v'loi parate. Maybe somebody once did me such a favor in the past and I didn't reward him. Mishum hocha mimani insha v'loi megaluli. And that's why people are going to refrain from giving me this information. They're going to assume that they're not going to be rewarded for it. Miyad immediately v'ayoyim elohovi esefa zichroinis divrayomim. He asked them to bring the sefa hazichroinis divrayomim, where everything is recorded, where he's going to check to see whether anybody ever did him a favor and he didn't repay them. The pasuk continues, Vayiu Nikroim, says the Gemara Melamed, Shenikroim Me'elim, even without anybody reading from these Sefer Zichronis, the words just read by themselves. It doesn't say Vayiu Kirim, it says Nikroim. In pasuk base it says, Vayimotzei Kosuv. The word Kosov seems to mean that it was just written now. Asks the Gemara, Kosav mi boyele. It should say, Vayimotzei Kosav. They found that it was a long time ago written that Mordechai saved Achashverosh from Bichson v'Seresh and was not rewarded. It wasn't just written now. Says the Gemara, Melamed Sheshimshi, the scribe of the king, who's called Shimshi, Moichek, he would rub out this whole story of Mordechai having saved Achashverosh. The Gavriel Kosav. And the Malach Gavriel would rewrite whatever Shimshi rubbed out. That's why it says Kosuv. Omer Vasi, Dora Sheb Shiloi Ish Kfar Tmarto. There's a Kal V'chaymet. Umak Sov Shelemato. Shel Yizchuson Shel Yisrael. Einoi Nimchak. If words written down here in a physical fashion, on a physical book, that are to serve Klal Yisrael, it's impossible to rub them out. Ksov Shelemalo. The mitzvahs that Klal Yisrael do, they get written in the Sforim, in the Beis Din Shel Maila, Leikol Shekein, even more so, that it's not possible to rub them out. This may possibly have to do with the sugya in Soitu Daf Chaf Aleph Amud Aleph, whether an Aveira is Mechaba Mitzvah or not. Can an Aveira extinguish a Mitzvah?